Hey guys, welcome back to Legion TD2. Let's continue our streak, shall we? Welcome to Egg, but I see no Graal, so yep. Sacred Steed. All right, what do we have for mana? Nothing crazy. Radiant Halo, yeah, but not super mana dependent. So I'll go Sacred Steed and might do an early reroll. I need this for tanking. The thing is, Nekomata start. I have a tank. I have no lifestyle, but I have a tank. I think I'm doing a very early reroll. Like, very, very old. Oh, I have one more, actually. I have two arcane tanks now as well. Gonna pick this for now. You know what? We're replacing this Neko. We're rerolling. What is this? I get Disciple as well, but no. Nothing else? 20 seconds. I don't know if I picked the right stuff now. So basically, I can play Sacred Seas now, and I can play off Darkholders and Disciples. Spell damage. Doing a king upgrade this time. Okay. Priestess on my teammate. Die Queen and Oathbreaker. Okay. So yeah, the Graal can take the spot of the Butcher. Kind of. And then, yeah, our damage is going to be Sacred Seeds, this. I have this as a tank as well. Sky Queen. It's 5. Like, yeah. I have this as well. My Spirit is so... I should have... There were other units I could have picked. I think there was Serpent and one more. My Spirit doesn't fit into this. I'm probably not going to build a single one. It is what it is now. 40. Wait. Is Nekomata Wigan too? I actually don't know. I guess it is. I wasn't aware of that. I wasn't aware that Nekomata's this week against the double, like against 40 here. Not gonna hurt me that much, but still. It makes my send on 5 bigger. It means less pressure on 3 and 4, kinda. This is okay, I mean, it's not gonna be hurting me or. I can still get 7 stacks. I see no reason to not do it. Like, I want the 7 stacks anyway in the long run, and I can't do 6 workers because then I have 5 stacks only. We could do Brute now. Wait, when is he sending? He's sending to an Oathbreaker. Probably going 4. I can definitely not go 4 though. That just doesn't make sense. Sacred Seed in front, okay. The Sacred Seed has to die quick, so the Sky Queen gets attacked, so that's fine. Another infiltrator, yeah. He's good 4 and 5, kinda. He's weak 7. So we could also do 5 into 7. Yeah, of course I get no send now. We're getting a golden buckler. I'll get the Graal in front of the buckler later on, because I need to make sure that I have it on the right spot. Not sending here. Okay, then we're going 5, I guess. Another 10. Yeah, I'll get some more income. That should be fine. We're gonna get... Wait, what are we sending? I just need to be anti-pierce, so more maybe even. I get 80 here, wow, he has also good push. I mean, I thought I had good push, but... at least I'm two-shotting these creeps, like... Yeah, he knows better how to pressure me. Oh, he has a honey flower now, okay. Then we're definitely going safety mode. Pressure. Damn, I didn't think I would do that bad here. Last game I was only Nekomata 4 and 2 tier 1s. Am I gonna miss gold? I think I'm gonna miss gold unless I get a snail here. This is bad. Yeah, on Miphium. This is actually really bad. Not as planned. That really sucks, but I hope we can return the favor. We're both sending 140. 40 resend, okay, that should be fine at least. I have no lifesteal this time though, I only have, well, the skill. And didn't even get the kill on the first creep. Okay, definitely more pressure on us this time. That's okay. Double honey flower. He shouldn't do a lot of that. He should do barely any damage, but the thing is the honey flowers tank a lot. They're actually more tank than their DPS, so yeah. It didn't really do the job. I at the same time I can't really send Drake though, because at that time he just clears everything super easily. Yeah, this sucks. Just wanted to make sure that I can get this. Although it's, I probably don't even want that. I probably want to get a sacred steed instead. I'm not expecting resend here, to be honest. I might be wrong, but I'm not expecting it. So I should do this and then disciple next round. Are we doing king ups? Or wait, are we going 7? I need to try it, I guess. Hope I can get a hermit before income. That would be 20 gold. I need 21. Man, I'm already not liking this game. Like, it's small things that make me fall behind a little bit. Anyone? Is anyone maybe leaking here? Except me. If I leak here, then it's over. So... I go hermit, I'm missing that one gold, so I gotta go double dragon turtle here. Hurts doing it, but otherwise I don't see myself Holtus. Doesn't show the range that it gives mana to, right? But I think it's just infinite. I think an extra snail won't do anything, to be honest. Yeah, I hate that I got into this position now. Wasn't aware that I would be that weak on 4. But it should be okay that there's a 7 cent, since Nekomata should be good on this wave. But I have not the frontline and not the lifesteal to support me. It'll be rough. After disciple though. Not the worst either. Teammate is leaking. It's not a big leak. Honestly, this one is fine. This doesn't hurt me as much. Anyway, I'm getting 130 gold instead. I mean, only Vasant, I guess. Which isn't an option for 8. Nope, certainly not an option. But yeah, I don't want to stack up too much arcane defense. I guess that's not gonna do the job. So I could predict that there won't be a send here. Why did I build the disciples so far in the back? Stupid. I just need to get a great boar next round. I know it's not too good to just add like so many of those. Yeah, no, that's actually stupid. Why did I build the disciples so far back? Because I mean, yeah, so it has more space in between and extra time to survive, kinda. But, I wanna build a great boar here, and, well, I kinda have to build a Starcaller Aura in front of the disciple later on. He leaks again? Wait, did he get a... Oh, he got a 60 recent. Wait, that means I'm getting enough gold though for Great Boar. Or I build up. No, I would still need a sail actually. I need to build a tier 1 in front as well. Which is probably gonna be a tier 2 to stop the wave. Stop the wave. And I'm sad to spend 50 for that. Okay, so let's see if our plan can still work. Of course, we're already so far in and didn't really work until this point, so I have my doubts that it's gonna work. But yeah, the plan is to get up Disciple Starcaller more, so we can get more spells off. They sent 9, I'm gonna be good 10. I think I'll add another Disciple 10. I'll be low value, but I don't really care. And yeah, I'm definitely weak 9. I have good frontline though. So I have that for me at least. Yeah, that will probably save my ass here. That I have so many golden bucklers and the great boar. Leaking quite a lot. He made us holy, no. Good. Good. So at least our king is doing fine. Didn't take that much damage yet. Since when we leaked, it was not the biggest monster king. Sorcerer. Actually, in this circumstance, Sorcerer on my Starcaller would be quite good. Wait, I'm missing gold? I can sell my tier 1. I actually leaked too much now. I didn't expect to miss that much gold. So this one is gonna get the Sorcerer. Then we're gonna make it a Starcaller. Not sure if it's already gonna be for next round, but... Yeah, let's do this now, and then... we can't go Creditor. So we gotta go Embargo. Creditor can make them get super fat. I mean, we go Sorcerer, like, forget what I said. But, yeah, I mean, they can probably go Creditor and make a lot of bucks. Yeah, not even 100% sure if I'll hold this. 100 extra? That's tricky. But we'll get it low, for sure. Barely got that spell off. Oh, he killed the boss. Yes, so good synergy units. Insane. Okay, we have enough gold, thankfully. So get a star color and give it the also dread, and then of course we gotta get a lot of sacred seeds now. But they also gotta survive, so yeah, I need a Grawl here, which will be an Ocean Templar later. I think it's alright, but yeah. Yeah, we gotta send together and before 13, we gotta send. They didn't go embargo, so in their position right now where they are ahead, they're not far ahead, but they are ahead. Best thing they can do is to go creditor. Can you let me know? Okay. Then I say 13. Let's do 13 then. Okay, we got 40, that's not really a send, so I'm not sure if we can really push. No, I need 335 here. I believe. Oh, he... wait. Oh yeah, Radiant Halo works that way, right? Yeah, it does. It gives more damage to the ability. And that is a viable option, to be honest. Grawl Pegasus, yeah, it's okay. I was thinking if I can go a bit cheaper, but even then I believe I don't get where I want. Like, the best would be Royal Guard here to get that one extra worker, but I got 40, so I should really full build. Like, get everything that I can. Oh, he picked redraw. Okay. I see. We are ahead now. I have a shutdown bounty. Wait, did they not go for? Wait. No, they both went creditor, I'm pretty sure. But I should have tons of gold. I'm a bit surprised. I mean, the earlier we send, the better, I guess. I need magic damage. Need to get through his front line so I can get to his squishy back line. Okay, so what's the best we can do here? Do we want to play off that star color more, or do we want to just get more mana in general? I think Disciple is good in any way. Okay, let's see. 150 undervalue. 36. My teammate didn't get a cent. Great! No pressure on our king then. Why did I even do king upgrades? If they don't send together. The thing is, I'm on 12 workers, so I don't know how this is gonna work. The frontline is weak, backline is insane. I would have liked to just kill that Ghost Knight, by the way, since it takes full damage from spells, but looks like I'm holding anyway. Now I kill the Ghost Knight. Wait, this was usually the Ghost Knight is a tank, right? This was the perfect wave. And it was the perfect time for me to just focus the Ghost Knight, as I usually do, since I have Disciples. But usually I don't have those Disciples and then I full focus the Ghost Knight. Now the Ghost Knight wasn't attacked at all. I don't know. Yeah, I don't get why they didn't send together. That's really, really weird. Just get a Pegasus next round. I mean, our send didn't really do much, but at this point... we have the, wait. No, there's no, they couldn't have gone embargo, right? They have to both gone creditor. This is so weird. Yeah, let's get another Pegasus. Starkholder did a good job, I think, last round. Honestly, it didn't do much more damage than the Disciple. It didn't die that much earlier. Okay, I guess we wanted to finish King. I mean, he could have let me do it. I don't know. Whatever. I probably hold for him here. 160 resend. I have to hold that. It could also be that they pick tax allowance. Or just a spell you get when you didn't pick anything. Sometimes that's the best option, actually. Don't think it happened here. Yeah, I'll fold at 15 and then do Drakos afterwards, I think. We're gonna leak quite a lot here. It's a lot of small creeps as well, though. I'm holding my lane. Still gonna be a King leak, but yeah, it's alright. Full King. Full region as well, so even if we take damage here. Yeah, we do. I mean, I made my guy leak actually, right? Wonder if I can make him leak again on 17. It'll be rough, but I think it's doable if I send big. Okay, let's get Ocean Templar, I guess. Make them survive longer. Another Pegasus. I could also get a Pegasus around Starkholder. They get more mana and give out the mana better. But I think they have decent tankiness. They have decent tankiness. Because if they get full mana, they actually they don't buff it themselves because they always give their mana to other units, right? They're not actually that tanky. But at the same time, I have nothing to really put in front. I can put a King Claw there now, I guess. Other than that, not really. So let's go 17. See what they do. But yeah, we have to kill that Sovereign guy. That's Teal's job. He's going for workers. He has a big queue of workers right now. I don't think I'm that strong, but at the same time, I don't think we can die 16 to what they are sending right now. So it should be alright. Gotta go 17 though. Because they might have done double workers too. Funny that I'm highest score now with 1-3. Yeah, next round I'll have... a bit. I rather want a full build here. Yeah. And I will not hold that. But we just need our king to survive. We're gonna be 80% full upgrades. I will have a decent clear. So hopefully with the spell damage from the king we're gonna do a lot. Yeah, we don't have the numbers leaked that we're gonna die, I think. Yeah, there's no extra units, it's just level 16 creeps. Should be fine. Oh, he's building multiple of those. Ooh, I think this might be a mistake. Oh wait, he doesn't have mana anyway. Huh, weird. He has too many different units. Forest doesn't do anything for me. Gali's surviving. I think I pushed too many workers. Oh, we need to survive. We need to hold now. Like, hold as much as we can. Because they're gonna resend here. Estimate total 86, alright. Then we're sending a hermit on top. Yeah, we need to kill them hard. Like they need to leak early. Well, the red eyes. I don't think they're gonna go 4 eyes here anyway, so. It'd be fine to have a big tank like that. They're doing full king. Good. Good for us. Good for us. I was a bit scared here. That's why we're surviving, for sure. So many Sky Queens. I'm not making him leak enough. They're gonna survive. They will live. They're not gonna die with full king. Yeah. Fine. My lumber is so bad. I wanted to at least send a witch, but not even close. Okay, so what we can also do, we can also get King Claws here in the second row. You get mana buffed. Of course, that way I have less mana for my Star Caller, but hey, it is what it is, right? Still haven't upgraded any Golden Buckler. Hey, let's get the first one now. About time. I think this might be one of the last waves, so I might as well kind of full build. I mean, the send I did here was nothing. Safety Mall is useful, because it doesn't die that early. But this is not going to make him leak. They're skipping another wave to go 19. Interesting. Keeping them on low income. Ooh, he actually does leak. I thought he would hold that. Okay, we got a re again. Oh my god, what did my teammate build? He built a couple of us. Outlive them. Maybe it is enough? It is enough, okay. Didn't see he had so many buffs, but I mean that made sense, right? Because we needed to survive as long as possible and just spamming tier 1 units is best you can do on a wave like 18. Yeah, that we were definitely behind early on. We were definitely behind. We were not doing that great early on. That level 2 and level 4 leak really hurt our economy. It really did. Look at that. But we lost a lot of gold there. 7 again. 7 leak wasn't that bad. 9 leak hurt a bit. 10 leak hurt a bit, yeah. But what I want to show here, layer net worth. So here, for example, our 5. Yeah, look at that. We are almost 50 behind already. So it's almost a worker. But I think we had pretty good income. Because look at that. Look at how we're catching up there suddenly. They both went creditor, right? They both went wait. You can send 11 with embargo? I mean, you can send 11? Like, I thought everything gets refunded for 11. All the king upgrades and mercs you sent. That's why I was so sure they went creditor, but they didn't go creditor actually. And look at that, at 10 they were ahead. But if you're ahead, you should go creditor. But through that, I was actually able to hold on to them in terms of value. I mean, I was still behind at 16. But I had the income at the end as well, I guess. Yeah, okay. I mean, it would have been interesting to see if they survive and then what happens on 19, but yeah, rough game anyway. Yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.